Hey everyone, and welcome to the 10K in 30 Day Live Weekly Webinar. I am your host, Vanessa Simpkins from TakeYourPowerBackNow.com. And today we are having an amazing girl chat. We're having an amazing conversation here all about how to attract and keep the man of your dreams. And so this is for you if you are a single lady, if you are in a relationship and you'd like it to be better, if you're maybe thinking, I don't know what these women are doing around the world, but I could certainly have a better relationship and maybe like what's going on with me, you know, what's wrong with me, is something I'm doing, maybe you're thinking it's past your prime or whatever you're thinking, we're going to have a really open, honest, candid conversation all about relationships, all about how to become attractive and magnetic to the man of your dreams. And joining me is a special guest today, Dara Fischetti. Welcome, Dara.
Hi, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I'm excited to be here with you. I'm going to introduce you all to Dara. She's a rock star for many, many reasons. She was actually a stunt woman on TV. Amongst other things, she's got an insatiable enthusiasm for health and fitness, personal development. She loves helping her clients create bodies and the life that they desire. She's actually began her career as a fitness professional and empowerment leader after enjoying many, many years as a dancer, a singer, an actress, and yeah, even a stunt woman on TV. She is now the creator of Supergirl Fitness and You Happy Ever After. She's an author of 2 books and she lives in Redondo Beach, just up the street in Southern California. And every day she fulfills her passion to help women and men live happier and healthier lives. Welcome, Dara.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, me too, because this is a really popular topic, especially for entrepreneurs. So before we jump in and get started, I do want to make sure that you can all hear us and that this amazing technology is working. So go ahead and type your name in the chat box and where you're calling from. Let us know that all of this amazing technology is working, that you can hear us. I'm also going to invite you to really show up and be here. I say this every week. I really do mean it. 90% of success is just showing up. So you made it here to the webinar or the replay, if you're catching this, the replay. So congratulations. And now really show up. You know, post your questions in the comment in the chat box, and I'll just stop and pause as we go through and answer them. Hey, Maureen, welcome, welcome. Chandra from Maryland, awesome. Okay, guys, so you guys can all hear us. This is a fantastic. Dara, the show is yours, my dear. Take it away.
Okay, all right. Well, first, I wanna say thank you again for having me on the show. It's exciting. First of all, I love being around you, Vanessa, and even if it's just online, like your energy just, I just always get that feeling like anything's possible when I'm around you. So it makes, in a good way, not in a bad way.
So thank you.
I love it. I love it. So let me again say thank you all for being here. This is exciting for me because let me just get started with my slides and then you can learn a little bit more about me and I can learn a little bit more about you and we'll dig into the meat and potatoes of this. So let me share my slides here. One moment. Okay, here we go. Perfect. Share. Okay.
Awesome.
So here we are. Can you see my slides?
Yes, I can.
Awesome. All right. Okay. So You Happy Ever After, that is my program where I'm helping women and some men live the life of their dreams and become, this one is all about becoming more magnetic and attracting the man of your dreams, keeping the man of your dreams. Like we said, if you're, maybe you're waiting for that relationship or maybe you're in a relationship right now that you're just has gone kind of tired and you want to reattract that man who's in your life. And this is an empowerment series that I've created. Now I like to say it's about repowering yourself so that you can create the life you truly desire. And I say repower because I can empower you, but you have the power inside of you. So I don't want to take that away from you. I want you to find that, to like reignite that power inside of you. So this is all about repowering yourself by applying some of the things and tools and suggestions that I give you. So in this webinar, you're gonna learn how to let go of some negative emotions and insecurities, how to feel and look more beautiful inside and out, because that is the key, is how we feel about ourselves. how to be more attractive, magnetic, and alluring. And finally, how to attract a devoted partner, a wonderful man, and keep him attracted to you forever. And at the end of the webinar, I'm going to give you three attraction techniques that you can try out today that make you irresistible. They actually do work. I've used them, my friends have used them, my clients have used them. They do work. They work especially good on the right man. And then some other free goodies are going to be at the end. And I just want to ask you a question. Do you feel that you are an attractive woman? You know you're an attractive woman, and your confidence, though, is a little bit shaky. It's been just starting to, like, be chipped away from some of the letdowns from the dating scene. And then, or maybe you've been in a past relationship that has caused you to feel insecure. Like, you've lost yourself, and you can't seem to find or act like the woman you know you truly are deep inside. Maybe you're also at the point where you are confused about what you really want, because it seems that at this point, does it really exist? Are you now faced with the idea of having to settle and give up on your dreams of being truly happy in the relationship you've always wanted? And, you know, does any of this describe how you feel? I wrote these down because this is what I experienced. This is how I felt. I was torn down from an unhealthy marriage and an extremely damaging divorce. I was confused about how I kept attracting the wrong men, even though I thought I was doing all the right things, and then more of what I didn't want in the relationship. I was getting worn out and frustrated from the dating scene, and, you know, struggled to feel like the self-confident, beautiful, attractive woman that I thought I was, or I've been told I was. I felt good about myself, and then it just kept, you know, getting worse and worse, and finally feeling hopeless and insecure about who I was and what I had the power to attract. At this point in my life, it was, you know, several years ago, I was at the point of giving up and resigning to the fact that it would be girls' night, wine, my dog, and it's, you know, that's fine. Actually, I love my girlfriends. I actually loved my life. I loved my dog, but I knew something was missing. So I had to figure out what it was that I wanted, how I could live my happily ever after. And I had to get super clear on what I was searching for and find a way to attract the right man for me. And most important, I had to learn to love myself. And the good news, I am happy, thrilled, super excited to say I found the right formula. And that is my picture. That's pictures of my wonderful man, Gary. He's awesome. So I finally did it. Now I want to share it with you and help women just like you to finally attract the man of their dreams. So my promise to you is by the end of the webinar, you're going to have a few breakthrough moments, even a few aha moments. Excuse me, on things like how you feel about yourself, how you think about yourself, the clarity you need, the way you begin to feel more attractive, magnetic, and beautiful. And all you have to do is stay tuned in, keep an open mind, and turn off all your distractions, meaning like Facebook and whatever else you have open on your computer. Grab a pen and a paper to take some notes. Just stay till the end of the webinar, because I'm gonna designate and dedicate the next 45 minutes of my busy schedule here, and I know your schedule is busy too. So if you're joining us, just stay focused, because I'm gonna share my winning formula on how to be more attractive, magnetic, beautiful, even irresistible to the man for you, the right man for you. And Vanessa did a little bit about introducing me, but I'm gonna go a little deeper. So when I was a little girl, all I wanted to be was a dancer. I wanted to be a dancer, a performer, a singer. I wanted to be on stage, make people laugh, whatever it was. I just, you know, there's those people that don't like to be in front of people and talk to people. And then there was people like me who just thrive for it. So I remember doing like shows for my parents in the house, and like, no, come on, it's time for the variety show. And I'd always make everyone sit down and watch me perform some kind of either crazy stunt or a dance thing or sing something. Yeah. And I started right out of high school dancing at Disney World, and I was a Disney princess. I danced in their shows and parades. I went on to dance more as an Orlando Magic girl. And then I started to, stunt performer at the Indiana Jones stunt show in MGM Studios. That's me falling off the building there with the slide for life. And I actually got to play fight for a living. It was awesome. And then I started doing more stunts and for movies and commercials and television. And it was super fun. I just loved it. I feel like people ask me, like, what's your dream job? And I have to look at them and say, well, like, I kind of already had it. It was amazing. But actually, life keeps getting better. And I do love my career now just as much as I loved doing that. But like my, even though that was fulfilling and that was fun and wonderful, like my other princess friends at Disney World, you know, there was always that someday my prince will come. I just can't help it. I'm still a little girl at heart. And there I was in a princess costume and hoping that I would find my prince. And I did find my prince, or so I thought. And I ended up moving from Florida, where I was living, to California. He moved out here and I followed him, and we started a life, and it didn't go so well. So my happily ever after didn't happen. After I did, you know, it wasn't like the relationship lasted almost 10 years, 11 years, but it didn't end well. And I was faced with, at that point, because I moved away from everyone in my family, my friends, everyone. I moved from Florida across the country to California. And like, now what do I do? You know, I had to move out of my home. I had to start my own business. Was I going to run back to Florida? And I said, no, nope. I had a decision to make, and you know, it was pretty scary, but I had to recreate my life. I wasn't about to fold or run back to Florida with my tail between my legs. I just decided I'm going to stay here. I'm going to jump and make this chapter of my life the best it's ever been, even better than before. And that's when I created Supergirl Fitness. And now I coach hundreds of women and men. I do have some men. And they, I help people every day with like fitness, nutrition, loving themselves. We talk about their relationships, how they feel about their body images, how they, you know, women that come to me and say, you know, I'm tired of how things are going in my life. How do I recreate myself? And this, I just love this. And I love the people that I get to work with. I then wrote my first book, and I got asked to be interviewed on a television show called America's Premier Experts, where I actually went back to Florida to film this. And it was an awesome experience. I got a lot of great publicity for this book, but mostly because it was like my first manual on how to create super health and fitness. And then a few years went by, and I decided time for a second book. And I created You Happy Ever After, because that whole phrase started with, when I was married, there was a sign over our bed that I had bought, and it said, and they lived happily ever after. And, you know, when I was moving out for the divorce, I took that sign off the wall, and I crossed out the they, and I wrote she. And she lived happily ever after. And I would look at that, and I'm going to create my happiness. I'm going to make my life the way I want it to be. And I want to help other women all over the world love themselves and create the life they truly desire. And that's when, now it's not about me, now it's about you. And it's about you creating your happy ever after. What makes you happy forever? It's about doing those things and loving yourself. And so it all turned out great. I recreated myself, my life. I started my own business, wrote two books, and I feel healthier, happier. I feel like I actually look younger than before. And my confidence has soared. I found my center. I love myself. And best of all, I found my prince. Mm. And after being divorced for almost 8 years and dating all the wrong men and almost giving up several times, I figured out how to attract the right man for me, my Prince Charming. And there he is. There's Gary.
Yay!
My Bruce Willis, I call him.
Yeah, you got a Baldy too. I got a Baldy, and so do you.
Yeah. It's awesome. So,
oh, nice.
Yeah, so we're extremely happy. And I want to just share with you, because I'm, you know, there were times I banged my head against the wall and I said, doesn't anyone, can someone help me with this? Like, what am I doing wrong? Because it seems like the advice you get from like your family and friends doesn't only go so far. So grab your pen, grab some paper. You may want to take some notes. I learned this from Tony Robbins, all the things that I, all the seminars I took from him. He's like, sit up straight in your chair with energy. Bring some energy into your body right now. Take a deep breath in, straighten your spine. And let's begin, okay? Let me also quickly throw this in that I'm not a doctor, I'm not a therapist. I'm going to share with you what has worked for me. I've been to countless seminars, audiobooks, I've listened, I've read books, I've hired coaches, I went to events, I spent years researching and learning from the best teachers all over the world. And I'm sharing that with you now. So know that the results that you get are determined by your dedication, your application, and your willingness to take on what you've learned today and to keep trying it over and over again. Just because it doesn't work once or twice doesn't mean it's not going to work on the right man, okay? And also, keep a good attitude. And when you're watching this and you feel yourself going negative and you're like, yeah, I know this, and you just stop for a second and see if you can soften your resistance around that. Yeah, I know this. See if you can just tune in anyway, and maybe there's something you'll pick up that you're that you haven't heard yet. And then I want to begin with a quote from one of the most beautiful women in history, and Sophia Loren. And believe it or not, this quote is on my vanity. And it actually, strangely enough, comes from my ex-husband. He one time cut this out and put it on my mirror because I guess he saw how I just stopped believing in myself toward the end of the relationship. And he would have these moments of being super loving and kind and then not. But it's true. Nothing makes a woman more beautiful than the belief that she is beautiful. This all comes from inside of you. So with that being said, I'm going to go back over to stop sharing my screen so you guys can see me and I can talk to you face to face. Okay.
Great.
Here we go. Okay. All right. So first I want to say one thing. If you are struggling with this, if you have been trying to find this man, if you've been doing all the right things and it's just, he's just not showing up, it's just take a breath, because it's not your fault. And I want you to understand that going through this is difficult and it's hard. And especially if you've been through some pretty rough breakups before, if you've had your heart broken, if you've had some dating disasters, if you've had, you know, a few things that make you feel insecure and doubtful about who you are and what you can attract, just know that insecurity and self-doubt are the killer of your true self. There's no way you can be who you truly are, beautiful and wonderful on the inside, if you don't believe in yourself and you feel really insecure about who you are. This also brings up the underlying fear that lives in everybody's heart, that fear that we're not good enough. And because we're not good enough, we're not going to be loved. So take a breath, because the first step in this is to let go of any guilt or shame that you have, that you have not been able to create this. Okay? So as you breathe, we're going to take you through this, through it like a two-step exercise to let go of that guilt and shame, of any failed relationships, of anything that you're holding on to that's making you feel not so great about yourself. Let go also for the need to validate yourself about your past relationships. Well, he did this, and you have to like explain to people that I went through that after the divorce. It was like so important to me to let people know, well, here's my side of the story. Here's what happened. And that need for validation keeps you stuck. It keeps you hanging on to that relationship.
Yeah, you just keep repeating over and over. You just keep recreating that same story. It's like digging a groove. You know, it gets deeper and deeper every time you tell the story. Yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. So what I'm inviting you to do right now is to accept, forgive yourself, let go, and move forward. Because none of what I say is going to have any kind of effect or impact or work for you if you're not starting with a clean slate. So let's clean the slate right now. I want to help you connect with your true self, your center, your heart, the beautiful soul you have inside of you. So the exercise is like this, and you can do it along with me now, or you can kind of just write it down and remember it for when this situation comes up. So let's say, think about a time when you experienced something that made you feel bad about yourself. And when you think about this, when you think about a situation, maybe it's something someone said or a fight you had in a past relationship or a breakup, try not to get too emotionally attached to it. Try not to get emotionally charged from it. Just see it. See it in your mind's eye, maybe off a little bit, and see it getting smaller. See that situation, maybe if it's a little bit big, and maybe even if it just happened, it may be, you know, bigger in your mind. See it starting to get smaller, and then close your eyes and say, I let that go. That was then, and I let that go. I'm here now. I'm okay. I'm ready for my future. And just giving yourself permission to let something go, to just let it go. Doesn't matter who was right or wrong. It doesn't matter if what they said hurt you. Just let it go. And then the second part of this is you're going to put your hand on your heart and take a deep breath in. Hold your breath for just one moment so that you can feel your heartbeat a few times. And then you're going to exhale. Preferably out of your mouth. Bring your hands down, roll your shoulders back, and say, I'm enough.
I am enough.
I am lovable.
I am lovable.
And I am loving. I'm enough. I am lovable. I am loving. And then the last part of this, you want to open yourself up to receive. Because nothing's going to get in. No man is going to get into your life if you are not open to receiving him.
That's a really good point. This is really powerful. You know, there are a lot of women who are super duper, you know, Miss Gung-Ho into business, like I was, you know, really live in the masculine energy, you know, of creating, of doing, of going out there and doing in the world. And men fall in love with women. I mean, a real man falls in love with a real feminine woman, and that aspect of a real feminine woman is the ability to receive. So if you're not comfortable receiving, you're not comfortable, you know, letting go and relaxing and being in the feminine energy, it's going to be really hard for you to even notice the guy when he does show up. So this is a really, don't just glance past this, because this is a really, the how of receiving is actually really difficult, can be really difficult for people that aren't used to it. Mm-hmm. I'm happy you're bringing it up.
So when I would hear that from women that were, you know, whether it was an event, they said, be in your femininity, be open to receive. And I never understood, like, what are they talking about? I am a woman. Like, what do you mean by receive? Like, I don't get it. And the simplest way I can help you understand this, if you don't quite understand the feminine open receiving message, is imagine how it's a feeling of quiet anticipation. It's joy of anticipation that something good is coming. So if you think about it this way, and how you felt when you were a kid, or even now on your birthday or Christmas morning, that you know gifts are coming. You know gifts are coming to you. You don't know exactly what someone's going to get you, and you don't know exactly, you know, like everything that's going to happen that's good, that you're going to receive that day, but you know it's going to be good. You know it's going to be from people that love you, and you know it's probably going to make you smile and be happy. So that feeling of that quiet joy of anticipation that something good is coming. That's where you have to bring yourself so that you are open to that man coming into your life.
So what, so he's, and this is really powerful, you know, because if you're not in that joyful anticipation, I remember there was a time when, you know, I was everywhere I would look, all my friends would be married, having babies. I was invited to weddings and I was like single beyond single. And I was like dating these trolls and I was, what is going on here? I was so angry, you know? Mm-hmm. So what advice could you give to people who find themselves really not in like any joyful anticipation, but that are in this like funk of what's wrong with me? Why isn't he here yet? You know, what am I doing wrong?
Well,
I know I stayed there for like years in that space.
Yeah. Well, the first thing is, it's not about what you're doing wrong, or it's about doing things that make you connect with yourself. Okay. So if you are always looking outward, like where is he? Why isn't he coming? Where isn't he? Like your focus is outward and you're not really taking the time to go, hey, you know what? It's not about like, why isn't he showing up? And your feeling is more like, hey, what I got, it's friggin' hot. And if he's not here yet, he'll come. That's okay. I'm going to fall in love with myself, because the more love you feel for yourself, the more you outwardly just radiate that. And I know that may sound silly, but
I get it.
It took me a long time to get there, because right out of that divorce, I remember my mom saying something like, well, just, you know, use your power. I'm like, what are you talking about? And I didn't have my power. I didn't have that like sense of self-love, because it was so beat down that I lost it. And I had to do little things. And this is what, you know, now that you have this clean slate, we go on to the power of passion, joy, and the authenticity of being truly who you are. Okay. So when you think about who you are, what interests do you have? What makes you smile? What's important to you? What's like your mission? And what, you know, you wake up in the morning and if you want a man who's devoted to loving you, you must be devoted to loving yourself.
Yeah. This is really the crux of your message. And it really is that, you know, most people think that, oh, the Prince Charming is going to come, he's going to make it all better. But really, you know, the way it works is you love yourself so much, you think that you really are all that and a bag of chips and more. And then, you know, men feel that. They pick up on confidence. And confidence can look like, you know, you could be 250 pounds and confident as fuck, you know? And a guy would be like, wow, she's gorgeous, because it's confidence. That's what they want. You know, that's what is attractive. It's not how big you are. It's not what color you are. It's that confidence. And the same thing is true about sales. It's that confidence, right? This is what attracts people and exudes out of you. So I'm really happy that, you know, you're sharing with people that it really is an inner thing. It's not out there, not looking out there for all that guy to make me happy, but go inside. And if you really look at, you know, some of these thoughts, so my thoughts were, you know, what's wrong with me? You know, that was not a very loving conversation.
Right. Yeah. Well, whenever you start a question, like we're always asking ourselves questions, right? Questions in your mind. Now you can ask yourself empowering questions or disempowering questions. Usually the ones are that go, why can't I get a man? The whys, or the, what's wrong with me? The whys and the whats usually are followed up with disempowering questions. The ones with the word how is a good word to put more into your vocabulary. Like, okay, how can I be more attractive to the man of my dreams? How can I love myself more?
Yeah.
How can I be more devoted to loving myself? And this was something that I know I lost during my marriage, because I stopped doing the things that I love to do. I remember I stopped doing like the things that made me feel really good. I used to run triathlons and I used to do, you know, like all kinds of crafts and like fun stuff like that. And I stopped doing those things because I was like lost. I was on this merry-go-round of trying to please someone else, trying to please someone else. And then just feeling like I can't get anywhere, but exhausted from that.
I think a lot of women do that. I did the same thing. You know, I think a lot of women do that. We get sold into all these fairy tales, you know, and all the cartoons and like the princesses, you know, Prince Charming's going to come and sweep us off our feet. And then we, you know, give our power away, you know, looking and needing for other people's approval, especially women who have kids. Oh my gosh. Right. And it's all about the kids and you lose your relationship or you give your power away to a guy to make you happy and you realize, you know, a couple of years down the road, oh my gosh, you know, I'm not doing the things I love to do. So
right.
Another really important call to action and invitation to get back to doing the things you love to do. What I did was I started going back and doing dancing. So I was like, you're a little performer, I love to dance. So I started doing Zumba classes and started meeting people because I'd pulled myself out and really kind of alienated myself and just like hold myself up. I didn't have any friends anymore, you know. So I started, you know, meeting community again and Zumba classes, and I started horseback riding again on a really cool ranch. This is really powerful. You know, it sounds like simple things, but inviting more joy and love back in your life by getting back to who you really are and doing the things that you love to do is powerful.
And because we treat others how to teach, or we teach others how to treat us, right? Mm-hmm. So in my past relationship, I realized I was teaching these men that my interests and the things I wanted to do weren't that important because I wasn't doing them. And I didn't say, no, I'm going to do this now and we'll do your thing. And it wasn't split like 50-50 or, you know, share the time like, okay, you want to go there, but guess what? This is important to me. I want to do this. I was always giving, and I wasn't receiving. I wasn't receiving their respect and their recognizing that I'm important to me. So my interests are important.
So this is another part of, you know, having a healthy self-love is really about having boundaries. And I think there's a lot about communication there too, you know. So hey, yeah, this, you know, there's a boundary there because women are natural. I think we're natural givers. We give. A man, and then we're always giving. I think I read this. I had to learn all these things because this was not part of my upbringing. I did not have a healthy relationship to kind of model. You know, I love my parents dearly, but they're severely dysfunctional. You know, people. I love them, but that's just the way it is. So I had to learn all this stuff, you know, and I always thought that if you wanted someone to love you, you'd have to, you know, give and give. So if you keep giving and giving and giving, the man's like, oh, she's happy.
Yeah.
She's still giving.
Yeah. Well, you know? Yeah.
If you want to receive from a man, you got to stop fucking giving. No, because a man, then he clues in. He's like, oh, wait a minute. Oh, something's going on here. Uh-oh. Oh, I got to start giving now. So you're either... You know, you can't have two people kind of giving at the same time. You know, you have to, if you want to receive, you got to stop giving.
You have to be open to receiving, and you have to display the fact that you're important. Your interests are important enough to you, and your time, and you know, confidence and devotion to yourself is not arrogance. I want to make sure that it's not about like, hey, I'm hot, and it's not about making the other person feel like they're nothing and you're better than them. It's about saying that here's who I am, here's what's important to me, and if we want to get together, and I'll honor your importance and your devotion to yourself, if you honor my importance and my devotion to myself, it's a shared thing. It's not like, you know, I chase me because my, you know, stuff is, doesn't stink, or you know what I'm, am I making sense with this?
Yeah, and I think the key word for you that I like hearing is, you know, this word devotion. And I had a friend of mine, Lisa, you know, in Canada, she was talking to me about this and I didn't get it. I mean, this was years and years ago and she was on this journey, and soon after she manifested her soulmate, she really got into this word devotion. And I didn't get it for many years, you know, and it really becomes a devotion because you love yourself more, you care about yourself more than what the other person thinks, mm-hmm. you know, so I don't care if I let you down, this doesn't feel right, so I'm going to do this, you know, right. And that's it. And you love yourself more than, upsetting somebody else or their opinion of you, you know, and that is highly attractive.
Yeah, because
that's a woman who's got direction. She knows who she is. Don't need you to make me happy. You know, that is like, wow. That just screams like yum, 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 bring it on, right? This is really what is attractive.
It's true. It's true. And then, so that brings me to what is attraction? Okay. So we're talking about, you know, what people find attractive. And I did a little bit of research, and I also did a little bit of interviewing some of my male clients, and found out that the things that men said, it's not always what you think. The first thing was like kindness, how kind you are, kindness to strangers and kindness and politeness. And you're being a positive person, like your positivity and having a playful attitude.
Yeah.
They said things like being able to laugh or laugh at yourself or laugh at their jokes. Men love that. They love it. And what other things? Oh, quirky interests. That was up there. Like, just if you have something that you're really interested in doing, don't be afraid to say, hey, this is my thing. This is what I like to do. That makes you attractive because you light up when you're doing what you love. And that light, that energy is really attractive. And what else? What other things were up there? Genuine interest in their life, too. So you can't be with a man and say, this is the stuff I want. And then not take an interest in the things they like to do. So, and that's hard to do with the wrong man. So that's how you'll know if you can be with this person, if this person is the right person for you, if their interests make you go, oh, you know what? That is interesting. I'm going to give you some of my attention so that you can tell me all about your quirky interests or your hobbies or things like that.
This is another powerful nugget. It sounds like a very simple, I don't want to wash over it because, you know, this is how I met my partner, Alex. You know, I had written a list of, you know, things that I was going to do in order to attract him. And one of the things on the list was, you know, go and do more fun outdoor activities like outdoor concerts and paddleboarding, because those are things I love to do. And so I went to this music concert, and of course I met Alex, you know, at the end of the concert. That's exactly where I met him, was at a music concert. And we both have this beautiful, you know, amazing love of music and live music and outdoor concerts. So yeah, you are going to meet him in, you know, as you go on this journey to self-love. And, you know, maybe it's exploring taking a course or, you know, I don't know, a cooking class or whatever, a trip to photography trip or something. You know, you're going to meet him in that shared passion. Absolutely.
When you are so into you, when you're doing your things and you're really into yourself, that's when someone else is going to get into you as well. They'll be like, oh, okay, this is cool. Especially if it's doing things that you both enjoy.
Yeah.
And then, because a lot of times with attraction, it comes up immediately. Women think about like the physical thing, right? They think about, and that was on the list, but it wasn't like number one on the list, but taking care of your physical appearance and loving yourself enough to do the things that make you feel good on the inside and the outside. And I have a few tidbits of a few little hints for this one, because when you think about the emotions within your body, they vibrate at different frequencies. And love is the most powerful. It vibrates at the highest frequency. So if love is so powerful, imagine how attractive and magnetic self-love is. If you love yourself enough to do the things that make you feel good, then you start to glow. Everything about attraction that makes you attractive is how you feel about yourself and how you feel about your life has a huge impact on how other people feel about you. And that begins with loving yourself and taking care of yourself too. Doing the things you love to do, and then also doing the things you know you need to do to feel better.
Yeah, I agree. Oftentimes that gets put on the side. I'll do it later. I call these energy leaks, you know? Oh yeah, I got to clean the garage, or, oh, I really got to, you know, get on this diet or go to the gym or, oh yeah, you know, and you kind of put it off, put it off, put it off, and it just drains your energy. Every time you think that you haven't done it, it's just another leak. So it sounds, again, like something very simple, but it's profound. It's the older I get, and I think I'm very young, but, you know, I realize that it really is these simple things that are the most profound. It is the things that not just that you want to do, but that you need to take care of. Absolutely. Because then you start feeling good about yourself. You're like, ha, cross that off.
Right.
Ha, did that. Ha, you know, and that is what builds your confidence.
And that's, I think what most people or most women do is they think it's this big thing they have to do. Like you said, like go to the gym. That can be a chore at the end of the day if you're really, if you've worked a long day or you have children to come home and take care of. And even though you should go to the gym, you know it's good for you. If you're not doing that now, don't set this goal that you have to go 5 days this week. Because then, no, if you haven't been doing it, it's hard to go from like zero to 100 in like a couple days. It's important to just start doing little things so you develop momentum. Because if you have a rock sitting there and the first push of that rock is hard to do and you're pushing that rock, and if you have to push it like this on this on an incline like this, that's going to be really hard to go from like this to that. But if the incline is low and you just start pushing it a little bit and a little bit and you start getting that momentum just a little bit more, and pretty soon just doing this is rolling the rock, and then you can get it to where you want to go on the steady incline. So if you're not doing the things you know you need to do to take care of yourself, start small. Start with the three things I like to say is, first thing, hydrate your body more. Drink more water. It's so simple. But when your body is hydrated, when you drink more water, not only do your eyes get brighter, your eyes get clearer and brighter, your skin looks fuller and more hydrated, your energy goes up, and the energy is what's attractive. You're mentally sharper too, because when your brain experiences, when you experience dehydration, just a 2% drop in dehydration, it can trigger some brain fog. So you want to make sure you stay hydrated. That's my first one. My second thing you can do to is. And this was one of the other things that men said was attractive, is your posture. Check your posture. I look around and I see a lot of women with this tech neck. And it's this, from looking down at your phone, from being on the computer, from driving, that forward goose thing in the neck that everybody's got nowadays. Oh my gosh, it kills me. Like, I want to walk up to women and just go and push their head back. So if you can take a minute to just roll your shoulders back, pull your chin back just a little, not like this, not like that, but just pull it back a little bit so that you don't have this anterior forward tilt of your neck. And then the third thing I recommend doing, this is just for physical body, is adopt a little stretch routine at night, especially for the hips. Because as women, that's our center of gravity. That our hips are, that's where our sacral chakra is, where we have all of the sexual energy. And if you're sitting for a long amount of time and you're sitting, you're blocking that energy flow. You're blocking and you're tightening up that area. So find a stretch routine. I actually have a few on my YouTube channel that I could also you can find a stretch routine. Anything that opens the hips. Anything, even just laying on the ground with the bottoms of your feet together in like a butterfly position, and take your arms over your head, just standing up, opening the hips so that you can move and flow and be a little bit more softer and sexier. There's nothing sexy or attractive about tension and stress in the body. No one's ever looked across a room and gone, wow, look at that woman. She's a ball of nerves and she's really anxious. Doesn't she look great? No one finds that attractive. So bringing yourself into a place of being softer and more relaxed within your body and opening up those pathways. That's my pure physical, like how to take care of your physical appearance in the smallest, easiest way.
And I think this is really doable. The first one is to hydrate. The second one is to check your posture. And it's true. I started eating raw foods and, you know, drinking a lot more water and green juices. And I felt like I had energy all day long, you know, really on. And the second thing, check your posture. My aunt used to always give us crap about that, is your green drink. My aunt, when we were kids, used to always, you know, put your shoulder, take your elbows off the table. So posture, you know, it is how you feel in your body, how you hold yourself, you know, can shift your state. And then also doing stretch routines. I feel phenomenal. The days when I do yoga, holy smokes, I'm like Mrs. Zen. Everything just flows. So there really is this, you know, a lot to opening up your energy centers. And this is ancient wisdom, right, from the yogis. So I love that. These are three really easy things to do. And I think the real key word here is, you know, consistency, because they're very simple, you know, but it's about doing this on a regular basis. And that's really how you make the change. Great insights. And thank you for those, Dara.
Yeah. Thank you. I also have a few little things that I want to throw in that are, so let's say you go out on a date with a man, or even if you're with a man you've dated for a while, there's things that can make you irresistible. I said I was going to share three things that make you irresistible. And one of them is your presence. How you show up, your presence, you are at that meeting. That means turning off your phone, looking the other person in the eye, and doing what's called active listening, where you repeat back maybe a few things that they're saying. And I like to follow it up with something like, well, that's intriguing. And I'll give you an example. When my first date with Gary, we were sitting there at dinner, we had sushi, and I asked him, like, what is it that, because I like to ask questions, I just who I am. I said, what is it that you've done in your life that not a lot of people know about, but you get really excited about when you talk about it. And he told me he used to make guitars. He used to make custom guitars. And he starts telling me about this, and he's just lighting up when he's talking about this. And I leaned in a little bit, and I said, wow, you made guitars? I go, that's fascinating. Tell me a little bit more. Or I like the words fascinating or interesting, or wow, that's so creative, or intriguing. And you just follow that up after you repeat something back that they said. So they know you're interested, that genuine interest. You're not checking your phone or, you know, just wondering how many calories are in your food. You're genuinely interested.
I think that's a really good tip. I mean, I can't stand sitting with people who are at dinner or something, you know, and they're checking and they're not really present. You know, you're talking with them and they're doing 10,000 things. So that's a great tip, your presence.
And even though women can do it, women can do it with women. Uh-huh. Women understand. But men, they don't like that. He's like, you're not listening. You're not listening. And I know I've heard everything he said, and I can repeat back everything he said, but he doesn't think I'm listening. And that's the impact that I'm making on him at that moment. So,
well, think about it. Guys are not multitaskers.
No.
Men are not like women. Men will do one thing really well. They're going to focus all their attention. They're going to get it done. Women can do a whole bunch of things all at once and just get a whole bunch of things done.
And when I'm with my girlfriend and I know I'm telling her a story and she's checking a text, I know she's still listening to me.
Listening, yeah.
So I don't get mad at her, but a man sees that and he's like, you're not listening. And so I think that's really
She doesn't love me. She doesn't love me to make me important enough to just pay attention to me.
Exactly. Genuine interest in their life.
And presence. Yeah, that's a good tip.
Yeah, presence. And then there's something that I learned at one of the Tony Robbins events was called mirroring. And it's how you create rapport with someone that you really, I mean, you could know them or you could just met them. And what that is matching something like you match their vocal speed, their vocal tone, maybe a little bit of their energy, a little movement here or there, and you mirror their movements and their tone and stuff like that. And because we're very attracted to people who are like us. There's been studies done that people will actually pick out photos of people they're attracted to that actually have a face shaped a lot like theirs.
Yep.
So we're attracted to ourselves. And they may not pick it up, but your unconscious mind picks this up, and the unconscious mind of your date. So if you meet a man and he's sitting there and he's talking pretty slow, he's pretty relaxed, his vocal tone is here, I wouldn't come in and be like, so here, let me tell you about my day, blah, 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 blah. And you're vibrating, talking fast up here, and you want to kind of match their tone, you want to match their level of energy. Not saying not be yourself, and certainly if you're out with someone who's kind of a slug, you don't want to be a slug either, okay? But let's say he leans back in his chair, like you're talking, you're having a drink, and he leans back a little bit. Wait a minute, and then lean back a little bit.
Yeah, this is really important, you know, with building rapport. The idea of building rapport, it can be applied to men or women. And it's definitely something that I do on sales calls with people. The first thing I do, it's the first thing in building relationships is building rapport, you know, finding out some kind of commonality, whether it's, you know, finding out whether they live over here or, oh yeah, you know, I had an aunt who lived over there, obviously being honest and having integrity, but it's very important to relationship building,
right.
Building rapport.
But there also is a fine line of something I call, you don't want to do the princess one-up. So what that means is, I call it either the Captain Toppy or the princess one-up. And that means when someone's telling you a story and you're listening to them, but they've said something, you're like, oh yeah, that happened to me once. And you're just preparing your response to what they're saying. You're really not listening to them. And as soon as they get done talking, you're like, yeah, that is nothing. It happened to me, but way worse. So it's almost like you top their story with your experience that was similar, but either way better or way worse. So I always say avoid the princess one-up. Like, here's your story, that's great, but here's mine. See that? See how mine's better? It's
Oops.
Really important not to do that.
Excuse me. I agree. There's a lot of people who don't really listen to me. That's just, you know, waiting for an opportunity to talk again.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then what was the last thing? This is something I learned that actually it really does work. It's almost like too easy, but so you're out on a date with a man and he, and it's going well and you want it to go well. Like you're attracted to him and things are going well. Believe it or not, make the first move. Like make the first physical move. Like maybe reach over and touch their hand or maybe touch their arm, something like that, and then take your hand away. So what you're doing is you're giving them a little taste of your affection or a love, and then you take it away. And a man will actually, they'll get like just very flattered that you went and took the first move. But then when you take it away, they're like, why are you taking it away? I want more. They'll want more. And men want what they can't have often. So this is a
really powerful known fact. Men definitely want what they can't have. You know, that's a kind of what confidence speaks. It's like, I don't need you. And, you know, I don't need you. So... You know, that's powerful. Mm-hmm. And I think the other part of this that I had to learn about was that men are actually, they're terrified of rejection. I mean, it's like death to men to be rejected. They have a real fear of rejection. So if you're making the first move and it's just that touch, it's just letting them know like, hey, I like you. And
yeah,
then they're like, oh, ho, whoa, ho, I'm gonna strap on my balls and come rolling over. You know, that's... That's how I see her. You gotta look at them. This when I took all these courses. I read all these books. Like I, you know, when I want to master something or learn something, if I make a decision, I'm gonna do it. Well, get out of my way. Here it comes. I'm gonna do it. So I was, you know, learning and reading, and I always remember this one woman. She taught me. She said, you know, when you look at a man, a really confident woman, she looks at a man. She's like, don't just like, you know, when you see a hot guy, you look at him and you get all nervous and you look away, but look at him. And like smile and keep smiling like 2, 3, 4, like it's uncomfortable now. Oh my God. And keep smiling at him and like send the clear message,
hey, right,
I'm into you, right? And that, whoa, man straps on his balls, whoa, comes rolling over, right? Oh, she's not going to reject me.
Right. Well, eye contact is something that is just, that is one of the things that on our first date, Gary and I, oh my God, our eye contact was just like, it just awesome. It just made me melt and let me know that, hey, we're on the same page here. But I forgot who it was I was listening to, but they said, you know, eye contact as a feminine woman, femininity is very powerful. And if you don't believe in it, if you don't think you're attractive and you kind of look down a lot, just for one day, as you're walking down the street, catch the eye contact of men, even men that are just passing, you know, you'll never see again, and hold it a little longer.
Yep.
That man will just be like,
she's into me, hey! And they might start rolling on over. Yeah.
Even if it's something that someone is just walking by, it is amazing the men who they light up when you do that. They just
pay attention to them. That's what they live for. This is a really interesting conversation. People are laughing. They're loving it. There's a question. Diane says, Dara, what would you say if you've always heard you're so independent and that's why you're single? People have told me that too. Too strong.
I remember hearing that too.
I have always said I am independent because I am single. It does seem to be a repetitive thing for me. What would you say about that?
Well, independence. I don't find independence being indicative of having to be alone. I mean, if you're independent, you can take care of yourself. You can do things. But this is one thing I had to learn. I can do a lot of things in my house. I can do and I realized that the boyfriends that I had he's like, let me do that for you. And I caught myself going, no, I can do it. No, I can do it. No, I can do it. And I had to stop doing that. And I even something so simple that he wanted to fix that I knew I could do. I was like, oh, honey, will you help me with that? Will you help me with this? And it softened a little bit of the independence around the things that aren't so important for me to be independent about. Does that make sense?
Yeah, this is a good lesson too.
I had to stop doing everything.
Men want to, they want to give to you. This is something that was this is a big lesson to me. Like man's energy is, I have a penis and it like comes at you. You know what I mean? Like we give, we come at you. Like this is a man, man's energy is giving, is providing, is giving. And if you're doing all the things, they don't get to feel like, hey, I am that man. I took care of her. I did this thing for her.
Yeah.
It has to do with receiving again,
mm-hmm.
You know, and this is Well, that's a good piece of advice. You know, women are receiving our vaginas, you know, receive. That's what we do. And so the energy also, you know, let a man do those things around the house for you, like, you know, that are an important. And again, if you're doing them all the time, if you're constantly doing the giving and the giving, he has no place to come in and give to you and receive, yeah. Which he might also be giving and giving his devotion, giving, right. If that's an important thing for you to have.
Yeah. Because I don't think independence has to make you unfeminine or not able or single for the rest of your life. I think you can be independent because you have to. I remember after I got out of my divorce, I told myself from now on, self-reliant. And I think self-reliance is a good thing because, you know, nobody wants to be with like someone who can't take care of themselves.
I think it's what women need to do. You need to be independent, you know, because then you can be in a relationship because you want to, not because you have to.
Because you need, yeah. And so practice being non-independent for little things that don't matter so much. That's what I had to do. Like I even if it's things you know you can do better and you're watching them do it and you want to grab whatever they're doing out of their hand and go, give me it, I'll do it. You don't know what you're doing. I had to stop doing that because I've been doing a lot of things for myself. I was divorced for, like I said, 8 years. I can, you know, except for things I need, like I have the most awesome neighbor who helps me with stuff and some great friends, but I can pretty much do a lot of stuff for myself and just as good as a man can. So I had to stop myself. I had to say, okay, let him do this. He wants to do this for you. Let him do it. And even if it's going to be a little bit of a mess and not like you're going to do it, let him do it.
Yeah. Good advice.
Yeah.
Great advice.
So, and I guess mostly what I had to do is to change my mindset around dating, around men, and around everything that was coming toward me. You know, like I had to stop creating what I didn't want. So what I was doing, what I noticed with dating, I kept attracting more of what I didn't want because I kept talking about it. I couldn't wait to tell everybody about, you know, this horrible date I went on, or how this guy did this one thing, or how this person, and I kept attracting that. I kept, because I believe for me, the second I talk about something, I draw it to me. That's why I'm really careful now about the things I talk about and the things I say, because for some reason it's like a concord, bam, shows up in my life. So I stopped talking about what I didn't want, and I started talking about what I did want. And I would talk about, like, oh, I want a boyfriend in Florida. I want him to own his own business. I want him to, like, have some kids, or, you know, that we could do fun stuff with. And I really started to get specific and talk about it. And I feel like that mindset is what helped me start creating more of what I wanted, that clarity.
Yeah, very powerful. Your words, your thoughts and your words create, you know, that's really, sounds very 101, but again, it really is your thoughts and your words. You know, words carry vibration. So the words that you speak, the, you know, things that you pay attention to, what you focus on expands.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. How are we doing on time?
We should be wrapping up. So, how are you with your slides?
Oh, good. Let me just quickly jump on over to my slides one more time, and then I'll jump back. I was, here we go. One thing I'm about my program is I created You Happy Ever After. That's a picture of, like, inside the membership site. So You Happy Ever After is something that I created because after going around for years and years and years and going to different seminars and going to different events and listening to different people talk and the best coaches all over the world, I even went to the island of Fiji for 7 days with Tony Robbins and did this life mastery class. I condensed all this information in all my notebooks, and I realized I wish someone had had the program that I created right now after my divorce. I wish someone had put it all together, like, here's your guide. You just went through a divorce. Here's how you rebuild yourself. Here's how you recreate your life. And here's what you do to attract the man of your dreams. So this is in my program. This is, you get all the different modules, and my clients they love it. They get in there, they do the videos, they do the I call them fun sheets because I don't like the word work. And I've developed some raving fans because of this, because it's something that I think women want and need, but how do you ask for this? Where do you find it? I know I had a little bit of a tough time finding, you know, the exact information. I had to put it all together from many different things. And here's one of my clients. She is beautiful, Katie. She came to me. She felt really bad about herself. She also wanted to lose a little bit of weight. She had a little bit of confidence issues. So after, you know, we worked together for a year, and then she ended up getting married to this wonderful man. She's so beautiful. Love her. Yay. So I'm going to go back over to here. What I'm going to do now is extend. Can you see me? Okay, good. So if you are a woman who is ready, who you know you're ready for a breakthrough in your love life, in your relationships, if you are tired of listening to those negative voices in your head that say, you're not enough, you know, something's wrong with you, if you want to kick those self-doubt gremlins to the curb, if you are ready to like finally meet the man of your dreams, and you're tired of being the single girl at those weddings, and tired of going out with your girlfriends and listening to them talk about their husbands or their boyfriends and the vacations they're going to go on and all that. If you're ready to finally create the relationship that you know you want, you're happily ever after, you're happy ever after, then I have something for you. I have set aside space in my calendar for 5 strategy sessions. I want 5 breakthrough calls for 5 people. And what these are, it's a 30-minute phone call with me where we go through and talk about and find out and uncover what's really holding you back. What is really keeping you from creating the life and the happiness that you truly desire. And, you know, we'll try to figure out, is it a mindset thing? Is it a self-esteem thing? Is it a limiting belief that you're still holding on to from childhood? You know, we'll really try to figure out what that is, and I'll give you some suggestions and some help that you can apply to start creating the life you truly desire, to start becoming the woman you know you can be, and then start attracting the man of your dreams. And, you know, well, like I said, it's about a 30-minute phone call. It's free. There's no obligation to buy anything from me. But, through this phone call, you're going to get a lot of clarity. You're going to get a lot of power for attracting what it is you really want. And maybe at the end of the call, you may want to join my group, because I've noticed that the women in my group, the women that have gotten the results around me, are the ones who are not afraid to take action. They're not afraid to reach out for help and say, hey, you know what? I'm banging my head against the wall here. I don't want to do that anymore. I need some help. I need some guidance. They're not afraid to do that. And they get that guidance. They get in that group. They get that accountability. And they start to up-level their results and create the life that they want. And that's my gift to you for being on this call. I only have, my calendar is pretty chocked. I got a lot of clients this week. So 5 spaces. If you are thinking about doing this, don't wait. Click that link. I know Vanessa's going to put that link in there for to schedule a session with me.
Yeah. Awesome. So what is that link, Dara, so I can put it in here for people? Do you have it on your slides?
Oh, no.
That's really generous of you, by the way.
Oh, yeah, of course. I thought I gave it to you. One moment.
Did you send it over in the email to me?
Uh-huh, I did.
Okay, so let me just go and pull it up for you.
See if I can find it here.
Yeah, so.
I got it.
I got it too. I'll put it here in the chat bar box.
And also.
But I also want to make sure that people can, you know, if they're watching this video on YouTube, or whether watching the replay after kind of it's expired here in Webinar Jam, and they're not able to click on the link, and it's kind of a long link. Is there an email address that you want to give out, or a website where they can come and contact you or find you on Facebook?
Sure. So my website is supergirlfit.com. And you can just find me on Facebook as Dara Fischetti. You can send me a private message there.
Great.
And you can also, I said there would be some free goodies at the end of the webinar. If you, if anyone wants to guess, there is a color that men are very attracted to when women wear this color. So anyone who guesses this color, I'm going to send them a copy of my book. So it's, Anyone want to guess?
Oh my God, that's a great great invitation. I'm gonna invite everyone here to send you a private message on Facebook. We're not gonna tell you what the color is. I don't even know what it is. Find you on Facebook. I think this is a great opportunity to get a copy of your free book as well. Find Dara on Facebook. A lot of people are saying thank you. Lots of colors coming in. I also want to invite people here. You know, there's been a lot of nuggets of wisdom that Dara shared here today. What's been your biggest aha, you know, your biggest or one nugget that you're going to take action on, or one idea or one perspective that you're going to, you know, take away from today's conversation? Because this has been just This has been a lot of fun. So thank you, Zara. And also, I want to, and I want to invite, you know, everyone here. You know, Diane says, thanks, just to let you know, you exude the qualities and beauty that you talk about. Sabrina says, yes, you're walking testimony into what you teach. Awesome work. Sabrina says, many nuggets made me realize that as a kid, I didn't get to celebrate birthdays at Christmas. So I never had that wild, fun, childlike anticipation of receiving gifts, which has rolled over into every aspect of my life, which is, that's a big breakthrough. What's been your nugget of, or your aha, you know, or something that clicked for you today that you want to take away from this conversation? Go ahead and type in the chat box, or again, go ahead and connect with Dara personally on Facebook. Her website's called supergirlfit.com.
Again, I have something for that person that said they didn't get to experience those birthdays and Christmases and stuff. I have a little exercise you can do for yourself. That quiet anticipation, what I would say is go into one of your favorite stores or just go into the mall or just driving to the mall and promise yourself you're going to buy yourself a little gift. Like, we always go to the mall or the store with like, okay, well, I need to look for this or I need to look for this. Just go and tell yourself, I'm gonna buy myself a gift. A gift that maybe normally you wouldn't buy yourself or for no apparent reason. But just drive to the mall knowing that you're going to buy yourself something special. Or, and it might even be just an ice cream cone or a Godiva chocolate strawberry. Whatever, like something small, just go there, look around, and then when you see something that makes you light up, buy yourself that little thing, or maybe it's a big thing. But try to get in touch with that feeling before driving to the mall that you know you're going to get something special, even though it's from yourself. Try to get in touch with that quiet anticipation of, oh, wow, I wonder what I'm going to get.
Yeah, great, great challenge. I love that. And Chandra says, thank you. I take away changing my words. So really powerful insights and breakthroughs here on the conversation. So I want to thank you, Dara, for being here today.
Thank you.
And I encourage everyone to go ahead and take advantage of Dara's offer to have a breakthrough session with her. She definitely walks her talk. Diane is saying, tips on a date, body language, and the help with balancing out my independence. With what the man needs to give and assist. That's her big breakthrough. Again, I invite you all to connect with Dara on her Facebook page or on her website. Take advantage here of her offer. She's got a link here that you can click, or you can meet her on her website. And I want to thank you all of these amazing people who are here watching. I always say, you know, 90% of success is just showing up, you know, showing up when you don't feel like it, showing up when there's fear, showing up, you know, when you've got other things to do. So thank you for taking this hour, a little plus, you know, here with us and being here live. And if you're watching the replay, thank you for showing up and making this time for you, because relationships are important. You know, no matter how much money you make, if you're alone at the end of the day, like, what's it about? What's it all for? So this has been a really awesome conversation. I thank you, Dara. I thank you all for being here. And I will see you all on next week's live weekly webinar. Again, my name is Vanessa Simpkins from TakeYourPowerBackNow.com. Wishing you an amazing day. Bye, everyone.
Thank you.